This is a production of PBS 39.
We're heating things up today. We're going to share some delicious dishes with you, from crab cakes to chocolate cake. So let's get cooking. Hi, I'm Amy Burkett. Welcome to PBS 39 Cooks. A is for All American. We've gathered over 100 recipes that you sent in from across the region, including famous feasts cooked up by your neighbors and friends. We also have dishes prepared by professional chefs from restaurants right here in the area. We put all of the recipes together into a cookbook for you, and a little later we'll give you all the details on how you can get yours. Well, we pulled 6 recipes from this book to share with you today. Here's a list of the food we'll prepare. Baby back ribs with cherry smoked barbecue sauce. Balsamic flank steak with spinach and shaved Parmesan. Sautéed crab cakes with sweet corn sauce. All American cheese stolens, mac and cheese, or as it's known to friends and family, macaroni heaven. And Mexican triple chocolate cake. Up first, the baby back ribs with onion rings and sweet potato fries. Executive Chef Joe Garvey teaches us how to grill our ribs to perfection. But before we get cooking, let's see where Joe does his best work.
It's a beautiful drive down to Bucks County. The Brick Hotel and Restaurant sits on the corner of Washington and State Streets in historic Newtown. Folks enjoy the fine dining and pleasant atmosphere. It's one of a few restaurants Executive Chef Joe Garvey owns in the area. He creates quite a stir in the kitchen. Joe isn't afraid to get his hands dirty as he prepares delicious dishes. This fun-loving chef slices and dices his way to perfection. While Chef Joseph is known for his fine dining fare, today he's grilling up a classic for us, baby back ribs.
Welcome to our kitchen, Chef Joseph Garvey from the Brick Hotel.
Thanks for having me.
You know, things are already steaming around here. We're going to have fun.
Real excited to be here. We're going to do some baby back ribs. We're going to do sweet potato fries, some battered onion rings. We'll simulate a little bit.
My mouth's watering already, so let's get to it.
Okay. We're going to start with a little bit of a rub. We got garlic powder, a little black pepper, some Cajun seasoning, salt and pepper, a little chili powder, and thyme. We're going to mix up our rub there.
You never have enough time, do you?
Never have enough time, that's for darn sure. Yeah. Then we like to sing while we cook. Amy, what do you want to do, right?
Yeah.
Here we go. You know that one?
I do love
sing
that
along,
one. No, you go ahead.
That's why they put me in the kitchen.
Today, what do I want to do? I want to make good food.
There you go.
I can't wait to eat it.
Okay. Well, barbecuing is a 3-stage process. Put your rub on. We have a court bouillon here, which has bay leaves, black pepper in there, and some seasonings. And what we're going to do is we're going to slowly boil that for about an hour. With barbecuing, you ever go to a barbecue and they have the chicken's black and it's raw inside, and you're like, what did I do wrong? Well, what happens here is we're going to use the ribs to tenderize in the boiling process. Then we're going to roast it. Most people don't realize. Then we're going to grill it.
Uh-huh.
Now, today we'll have to simulate a little bit, so we're going to roast it, and I already grilled a little bit later on, so we'll get that started.
That's probably the big mistake that people do when you grill. They don't go through the whole process.
Yes, and then you wonder why the ribs are tough. You know, really, the barbecuing at home is just as easy. It's just going through the process. You can actually do some of these stages ahead of time. So in the morning, if you want to get up and do some work, and then later come back and do that. So what we're going to do is we got our ribs all boiled, ready to go.
About how long does it usually take to boil them?
I like an hour.
Okay.
I like about an hour, but I do a slow boil, as you can see here. Then I took a little of the court bouillon in the bottom, okay, which has a little port flavor and a little stock in there, and it creates a steam in the oven. So then what we're going to do is we're going to put the ribs in the oven there. Okay, I got some other hot pans for some other dishes we're going to do later. Okay.
Good.
All right, so now while that's roasting, we're going to come over here. Can you help me out for a little bit? Because I'm a little tired today.
I want to be used.
Okay. There you go. Can you do me a favor, mandolin some sweet potatoes for me?
I can do it.
Okay. We're going to make some sweet potato fries. Now at home you can use a knife or however shapes you want. Then we're going to, as you're doing that, I'm going to take a little Cajun seasoning, okay,
yeah.
And cornstarch, okay? Real simple dish. okay? This is a big Southern dish right now. I like to make a mess in the kitchen, too.
Everybody loves Southern food.
Yeah, everybody.
No,
right now.
I've been in the South for a few years and just love
right now,
Southern
it is
food.
So big. Comfort food is back in because I think we're all on diets. As you can see, I'm not, but
you're
what are you going
to
do?
You're
I'm a chef,
to
yeah.
Me.
That's what I always say. The guy likes his food, right?
That's a good sign. It's kind of like a hairdresser who doesn't have nice hair. If you're a chef and you're too thin, you must not be that good.
Good point.
You think?
I appreciate the compliment.
Okay.
Then we're going to do, we're going to drop the fries in there. Oh, nice.
Excellent.
Okay, that's why our ribs are cooking. We're going to keep them in there for about a, I guess about what, about an hour in the oven as well.
Okay.
The whole barbecue process is about 3 hours, okay? All right, we're going to get rid of that.
So you've got to plan ahead when you're having that big party at home.
Mise en place, the state of readiness, okay?
Ah.
Then we're going to take our beer batter mix, okay, which is baking powder, Cajun seasoning, eggs, flour. We're going to make a nice batter mix, okay? Stir it up for me if you could. Add a little more baking powder in there. Now the Cajun flavor adds a little spice because when you're dealing with barbecue and you have some sweet flavors and it's actually good to have a little spice to it so the taste, you know, the contrast.
And my mouth's not going to be on fire.
No, you're going to be fine.
Okay.
No, you're going to be fine. Don't forget the beer. Our chefs like our beer. So
beer.
We're going to mix a little of that in there.
Just a little beer.
Whip that up for me if you don't mind.
I can do that.
Okay.
I think I can do that.
Then we're going to come back over. And we're going to drop that. Oh, fantastic work.
Like
you're a natural. You're a natural.
This is why I needed real chefs.
Yeah,
I
you're
couldn't
a natural.
Pull this off.
Nah, you're kidding.
Yum.
Oh, yeah.
Now, there's something special about real fried onion rings.
Yeah, they're fattening.
But they're so good.
Yeah. We actually added a little bit of flavor to this. Those seeds, like I said, the Cajun season will give it a little bit of a bite instead of just a regular onion ring. Cut your onions a little bit thicker. Okay. Oh, yeah, these are good. Nice. Okay. One more because we want a little height, right? You like height on your plate?
I like height.
That's key, right?
I like a lot.
Okay.
That's the problem.
All right. Now we're going to come back over, grab our plate here. Okay. How's our sweet potato fry? Oh, look at that. Looking good. Looking good. Now we got our onion rings. We're gonna.
And that was Johnny on the spot.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Well, it might take a while to do good grilling. It's no time to do these.
Not at all.
Yummy onion rings.
Look at that.
What about, do they need a little longer?
They might need a little longer here. No, actually, a little. Yeah, the cornstarch makes them look lighter, but as you can see, they're done. So we're going to put
fantastic.
That. See how they have a nice little coating on them?
Excellent.
Okay, you don't want them too, Chris. Now we're going to come back over here. Let's go check on our ribs.
Okay.
Okay.
The magic of television.
The magic of television. Oh, yes. Chef. Fantastic. Okay, we're going to check on that. I'm going to put my other ones right here. I got that there. Fantastic. Now, keep in mind, when these get done, we would want to grill them.
Okay.
Okay? You're hungry?
I am hungry.
You're hungry? Good.
Is it just a quick grill afterwards because you've gone through the whole process?
Yeah, a lot of people don't realize with barbecuing, the grilling process is really not as much. It's like a steak. Most chefs will never admit this, but in a restaurant that's doing 300 dinners, here comes my one secret today. When you're cooking your steak, they usually mark it. Once you lock in the flavor of a grill, most people finish in the oven. Barbecuing's the opposite. It's the oven and the water and the boiling process, and then you finish on the grill. But really, the flavor has already been locked in from the tenderizing process.
Your secret, secret number one of the day.
Okay. Can't give too many away now.
But we appreciate it.
You got it.
What
now
are we
we're
going
to come to the ribs. We're going to come over and check them out. What do you think? How are they looking?
To die for.
Whew. I'm starving. Okay. Let me put them right here.
Excellent.
Okay, let me get rid of these old ones I had over here. Change my tongs. Always use a fresh pair of tongs when you do that.
Mm-hmm. Good.
Very good.
Cleanliness, very important.
Very important.
Keep everybody healthy.
Very important. Okay.
Yum.
All right, now we're going to do is we're going to build our ribs. And then you're going to eat, right?
Yeah. You know, there are so many perks to this job.
Yep.
Today it's eating.
Okay, we'll put them right up here.
You mentioned they didn't take long to
nah,
grill.
The grill's real easy.
You did
just
all
like
the
you said,
prep
just mark them up real nice. Okay. Well, man, they do smell good.
Everything smells fantastic, Joe.
Okay. Voila.
Woo!
Oh, beautiful. Now, in the summertime, obviously, you want to have a nice, there you go.
Slap an extra one in there.
Okay.
Load it up good.
Load it up good, little southern style. Create a little height. Very important, right?
Oh.
And you remember, the key to this whole thing is with a little love and some tenderness.
Love?
With a little love and some tenderness. Voila.
I love it.
Are you hungry?
I am hungry. Where do we sit? Should we try over here?
Yeah, let's sit
one neat. Quick little bite.
Yeah, there you go. Well, chefs like to...
Go for it.
Try what?
Where's my baby one?
Room
I'll
life.
Do it. I'm crazy. Call me crazy.
They are tender, aren't they? Seriously. Wow.
Ah!
Let's sing. With a little love and some tenderness. Very nice.
I love it.
Okay.
You know, Chef Joe Garvey from the Brick Hotel, thanks so much for being with us. We love it.
Hey, thanks for having me. Enjoy.
Okay, well, my mouth is still watering, but hang on. We're just getting started. Our next dish is balsamic flank steak with spinach and shaved Parmesan. Since Italian is the number one favorite style of cooking in America, and grilling is the number one cooking pastime in the USA, it's only fitting to include this dish, cooked up by our Italian expert and author, Sharon Sanders. Our next chef might be petite, but she packs quite a punch in the culinary world. Sharon Sanders is an authority on food and life in Italy. Sharon's zest for cooking comes through in her most recent book, Cooking Up an Italian Life. When Sharon isn't busy baking in her kitchen, she's writing. Sharon writes extensively for national publications, including Cooking Light. Sharon lived, loved, and labored in Tuscany for several years before moving to the Lehigh Valley. Sharon Sanders brings a taste of Italy to our All-American show.
Thanks for stopping by our kitchen today, Sharon. We appreciate you coming, one of our favorites here at PBS 39.
It's always fun to be here, Amy. Thank you.
Let's get started. Where do we begin?
We're going to make the balsamic flank steak with spinach and shaved Parmesan. First, you need a flank steak, right?
Okay. Now, flank steak, is that one of the more expensive cuts? Or?
It's a moderately priced cut. I like it because it's thin, it cooks quickly, there's not a lot of waste, and as you can see, it's pretty lean. If there's any fat clinging to it when you buy it, you can just trim that off. Now, the important thing about flank steak is to slightly tenderize it before you marinate it. Can you see that there are these sort of threads or fibers running the length of the steak? The flank steak is actually the flank of the cow, the belly part. Now, these can be kind of fibrous, so you just want to take a sharp knife and just score, like not cutting through, just like scoring the surface. This is going to allow the balsamic vinegar to permeate the meat fibers and tenderize and flavor them. So we're just going to do that. Now, this is a little tip I like to tell people for marinating. They can use a Ziploc bag, put it in a dish to stabilize it, but then you don't have to wash the dish. You can just, you know, take out the bag and throw it away.
It's all about saving time.
Well,
we love
my whole
time.
Approach is, as a home cook, make it simple. I want to enjoy that time on the patio with my guests. I don't want to be in the kitchen cooking. Now, balsamic vinegar. You probably know it as a salad dressing. Mm-hmm. You probably go to a fancy restaurant and order the balsamic dressing. Well, it also makes a wonderful, flavorful marinade. You really don't need anything else with it. This is one of my favorite kitchen tools. I recommend everyone gets an offset measuring cup. You know how, did you ever measure liquid and you're always
right.
Like
always
down
bending
squinting?
Over.
You don't have to do that because
it's
the numerals.
Graduated and the
yes,
numerals are so
it's
you can
fabulous.
See it from on top.
It's, you know, when you think there's nothing new in the world of kitchen gadgets, you know, there's something like this. Now, balsamic, people know it as a sweet vinegar. The reason is it's made from pressed wine grapes that haven't been fermented. When you start to make vinegar with wine, most of the sugar has been eaten up in the fermentation process. Well, this has all that natural sweetness of the grapes. And then it's cooked down to make it even sweeter. We're going to pour this in here, and then I ask you to just massage it lightly to get that vinegar
massaging.
All through.
Yes. This I can do.
Yes. And let's just seal this up. Well, actually, we'll just pretend it's sealed because we're going to cook this right
extra
now.
Extra careful.
I'm going to reach over here, and we've got our griddle heating up here.
You know, if the cow could talk, it'd be saying, ah, right now, because it's getting a great massage. Mm.
So the balsamic is reduced, the grape juice is reduced, then it's aged in a series of wooden casks like oak and mulberry and chestnut. It's made in the area of Modena in northern Italy. And all those woods impart very special flavors, and it's just wonderful. You could embellish this marinade, you could put rosemary in it or garlic, but, you know, I think there's really no need to. I want to keep this as simple as possible today to show you how you can have a fabulous main dish. Now, this is great. The The balsamic flank steak is super, cooked over charcoal or a gas grill. Today we're in the kitchen and we're using one of these wonderful griddle pans. It's a coated cast iron griddle. The other side is flat for pancakes or crepes. It's very versatile. On a day when the weather's bad, you can't grill outside, or you don't have, you know, your grill helper. That would be my husband.
We all have one of those. It's a good thing.
Yeah. So we're just going to oil this. Now you see that smoke coming up. We're going to pretend this is marinated for an hour or even longer. You could marinate this, you know, the whole day.
Does it enhance the longer it's in, the more enhanced flavor?
Well, yeah, it will have a little bit better flavor. Now, get that sizzle. Oh, would you mind putting that aside, Annie? Thank you so much. Now, what you want to do with the flank steak is get a nice char. Now, we're going to char it on the bottom side and then flip it. You can turn it a couple times. Usually when you're grilling foods like a roast, you don't want to be flipping them too much. But with the flank, it's very thin, so you don't want it to dry out. I like to cook it to medium rare. That's 145 degrees on the inside. And the way we're going to tell is with this wonderful gadget. This is my gadget day, but gadgets make things helpful. This is a digital instant read thermometer. I'm going to flip this over. Now, this is really too early to test it, but I'm just going to demonstrate how we would do this. Oh, see how beautiful that is?
Oh, it is beautiful.
Just that aroma?
I don't know. Television.
Now, you have to insert this about 2 inches. Now, obviously, this is a very thick flank steak, a very thin flank steak. So what you want to do is just put it in lengthways, and you want to check for 145 degrees.
Okay.
Now, I have one already grilled. If you want to grab that, Amy, and bring it over here.
Presto, again, the magic of television.
I'm going to carve this up. And if you want to start arranging the greens on the plate, you grab the plate back there. Today we have baby spinach, which is a nice, mild green.
You could also use arugula, which has a little more pepper. You could use a mixed baby spring greens. This is radicchio. We're putting some in today. It's a type of chicory. It looks a little bit like red cabbage, but it has a little peppery bite. It's a nice addition and it's good color. Now, do you remember our meat fibers? They were running lengthwise. Now, the secret to getting a super tender flank steak, score it, marinate it, grill it properly. But then when you carve it, you don't ever want to carve it going with the long way of the steak, because then you get all these like stringy fibers. You want to cut across those grains, and that cuts all those fibers into tiny little chunks that makes it so tender. This is beautiful. It takes just 15 minutes to grill. And then you can have your greens. You can have these greens all washed and in the refrigerator. Now, you talked to us about you like yours medium rare.
Yes.
If folks do like, it's 140 degrees for medium rare.
Right.
What is it if you like medium well?
Well, go up to about 160. And once you grill it, take it off the grill and let it rest for a few minutes before you carve it. Now, this is very nice. You got that nice pink in there. Now, we're going to dress it with extra virgin olive oil, which is the first cold pressing. It has wonderful olive flavor.
And it's incredibly good for your health, isn't it?
Italian food is not only tastes good, but really is helpful. Now, this is the ingredient that brings everything together.
Parmesan cheese, real Parmesan
cheese.
Not from the can that I sprinkle.
We're going to shave shards of it with a vegetable peeler, again, gadget day.
Okay.
But these are things that home cooks can really use to simplify cooking. Shave strips of it on top, and the Parmesan is nutty and sweet. It brings together all the flavors of the dish. This is really a main course. It pleases salad lovers. It pleases meat lovers. It's wonderful to have on the patio on a summer evening. Serve on the side this is an herbed focaccia, an Italian flatbread, or simply some crusty bread. Isn't this lovely?
It is.
The colors.
Gorgeous.
It's just so appealing. And the cooking time is 15 minutes with the flank steak.
Fantastic. But you know, my favorite part.
Amy, somebody has to do it.
I have to taste it. It's my job. Somebody has to do it, and we work so hard. You can never have enough Parmesan cheese, can you?
No.
Good.
Italian food is all about the simplicity, the quality of the ingredients, and just coming together with friends to enjoy a dinner like this.
Tre magnifique.
Molto buono.
Sorry. French in my background. Sharon Sanders, thank you so much for being with us, cooking up an Italian-American style dinner dish for us that's quick and easy, and you can find the recipe in our cookbook, so if you need more details. Appreciate your time.
Thank you.
We've got many more recipes to cook up here in our PBS 39 kitchen. Don't go away. Crab cakes with sweet corn sauce and all-American cheese stolons are next. Find out how you can get your hands on these tasty recipes and those you and your friends sent us. They're here in our PBS 39 cookbook, A is for All-American.